Hi, welcome to Takavi Channel, your solution provider. I am Sophia, and today I am going to give you a tutorial on how to use Photoscape. Well, unlike Photoshop, Photoscape is a free program. It is simple and is very easy to use, and therefore this is very popular among the younger generation. First, you should know the type of editor you wanted to do. So, from this screen, as you can see, these icons here are called the Photoscape screens, or just screens. We have here the editor, which enables you to edit a single photo, the batch screen, or the batch editor. From the word itself, it allows you to edit by batches. Then here's the page screen that allows you to make one photo by merging photos at the page frame. This one is the combined screen. It is where you can put together multiple photos horizontally, vertically, or in a checkered pattern to create one photo. And this one is the animated GIF screen. So, this enables you to create one animation using multiple photos. By the way, GIF stands for Graphic Interchange Format. So, let's tackle the editor screen first. I'll just tackle the rest of the screens on my next tutorials. So, what we have to do is to click Editor. What we're going to do here is to choose our photo from the left portion of your screen. Okay, so I'm going to choose this one, this baby picture. So by the way, this whole area here is called the page frame. So, okay, I'm going to explain one by one the functions here. So these four boxes here are the color editor. You can change the photo to sepia, okay, just like that, to grayscale, okay, and to black and white. Or you can change it into an invert or a negative, just like this. So by the way, if you want to undo your pictures or your edits, you just use the Control Z command. So press in your keyboard Control and then Z, then it will undo the edits. You can use these tools here, as you can see, and I don't think I still need to explain each, since it is very self-explanatory. For example, the resize, the bright color, the auto level, the sharpen, the filter, it's up to you. You have to explore for this one. Okay, the next thing that we're going to do is to put a frame on our photo. So I'm just going to click on here and just then choose frames from this varieties of choices. So, let's say I'm going to use the pattern 16. Okay, that's perfect. I'm going to adjust the frame to 200% so that it would appear bigger. Okay, another feature from this Photoscape editor is the object. So, I can put on my text in here. So just click on the text icon and another window would pop out. So I'll type in, let's say, my beautiful baby. I'm going to change my font to French script. Oh, I hate that. So I'm going to choose another font, which is the Freestyle script. So I'm going to apply an outline and my photo, change the outline to dark blue. I'm gonna apply shadow here and change that to blue. Okay, that's perfect. And then I'm going to press OK. So I can relocate the text anywhere I want in the picture. I can scale the size of the font by just dragging it here. And then that's perfect. The next thing is that another feature, is you can add another photo in the picture. So just click on this one, this icon. It's called the photo icon. Okay, you click on photo. And then you can choose from your files the perfect photo wherein you wanted it to put in your Photoscape editor. Okay, this is it. You can drag it anywhere you want. You can resize it and you can relocate it wherever you want it. Okay, so it's as if the baby is looking at the butterfly. Very good. Perfect. Then, if you're done editing, you can save your picture. Let's say just by clicking on this one, click on save. And you can choose the quality of your picture. I wanted my quality to be very high. That's going to be 100%, and I'm going to press OK. And that's it. Very easy. By the way, please watch out for my Photoscape basic tutorial part 2. For more tricks and tutorials, visit www.techiv.com. And thank you!